During a recent assignment to West Germany, I found myself with the urgent need to look inside of an air channel to help a friend. And because we couldn't figure out how to open the air channel, I, in a tired mood, just looked at Amazon and saw this nice little camera for 15 euros. And here I wanted to unbox it and show you a little bit what it can do. And alas, thanks to the magic of Prime, literally the next day I had this box in my hand, and you see here in the back, of course, the large asset tag. And now when we open it, there is not really much inside. First of all, we find here the actual endoscope camera. Then we get a bit of documentation. And then we get a bag with small parts, which you see here. First, we have this adapter, which is for connecting it to the desktop. And then we have a little mirror and some reflectors, which I didn't really need during my experiments. And I wanted to use my Cosmo communicator. So you see, I had to put this included adapter, because here in the back it's a micro USB, and I put this adapter together, and then I could plug it into the Cosmo communicator in order to start looking at things. And the cable, as you see here, it's a bit rigid, so you see it holds the position. And this thing here is also interesting, because it has a somewhat flimsy, but it has rheostat, which allows you to control the brightness of the LED. And when it comes to actually taking the thing online, you need to, of course, select the right camera app. The one which I use, I'm showing you in the show notes. And then you see here, we take the adapter and we plug it into the left-hand side port of the Cosmo. And then we click connect USB camera. And then normally it connects. You see here, USB endoscope, we say okay, and now we are connected. And if you look carefully, you also see here on the top, the lamp has lit up, and we can control its brightness using the rheostat, which I just mentioned before. And at this point, essentially, you're looking at an endoscope camera, albeit with a somewhat flimsy connection, as you see here. So we reconnect. And now we can take a little look around the lab. Let's start off by looking around the lab. I'm gonna readjust this a little bit to give you a better view of the screen of the Cosmo so that you see what I am seeing. Generally, you see the endoscope camera, she does what you expect of it, but of course there is no autofocus, so you see there is a limit to just how focused things are. And what is interesting is, if I get very close, you see that the quality is actually pretty good. Now I'm like 10 centimeters away from the part, and you see that you can actually read this pretty well. And as I go away farther, of course, it loses the focus. So you see, the closer I go, the better it gets. So this obviously makes it quite ideal for some macro applications. And yes, depending on the amount of light, I mean, here we are in a well-lit studio. I was in this place where the light was not very bright. And you see, the camera support light, it really does make a difference. So it's quite strong enough, as you see here. And then finally, there is also a button, but the button didn't do anything for me in my testing, probably because my application doesn't support it. And just so you see, this is how the front looks. You see in the inside the camera sensor, and around it there is the corona of the lights, which you can make brighter or darker using the rheostat, which I showed you before. And one more nice thing, the moment you plug this camera into the phone, even if you don't have an application on it yet, you get light, so you can also use it as a small emergency torch if push comes to shove. And before we go away, I wanted to illustrate you one more important problem. You see here, the situation is very good because I have the desk and I can move the camera very close to the situation at hand. In practice, like for example in the thing which I was working with, the problem is that if you can get the camera directly like this to the point, usually you can also look in. So before you buy this camera for a specific application, you need to think whether, I mean, okay, you see the cable is quite rigid, but you need to think whether you are also able to move the camera into the position to actually see what you want to see. Or whether it's not possible. For example, if you would have to go around a corner, it is not always possible if you only have a small access manhole to fit it through like this. And yes, I do want to say one more thing about the accessories. You see here the angled mirror, you screw it on the front. But then you also get this little magnet, which in theory it fits here into a hole in the back. But the problem is that the holding sleeve that you have here, it can slide on and off easily. And so I would personally be a bit concerned if I would have to use the holding sleeve. Because you see, I'm putting it together like so. Then I'm putting this down here like so. And it already jumps out in the back, so now I put it back in the back. It's all a bit fidgety, as you can see here. And even if I do attempt to push it together like this, so like this, even if I do push it together, you see it is not too rigid. So, I mean, I wouldn't use the little magnet to pick up anything excessively large. And yes, for completeness sake, you see this is how it looks when it's completely assembled. So we have the little magnet here in the front, and here we have this, and there is a groove, and this has to slide into the groove. This is how it works. Now we have a little magnet in the front, but I'm still not particularly happy with it. I would not use this, at least for my personal applications. So, and this is my opinion about the little endoscope camera. And to get to the end of the story, this picture actually was not made by the endoscope camera, but it was made after we cut into the ceiling. Because you see here, there were these two wire splices, which were unisolated, and they just touched, and when they touched, it shorted. And so in the end, even though we had the endoscope camera, in the end we still had to cut in. But nevertheless, I hope that you liked the video, and like and subscribe, and see you again soon, because there's so much more to talk about. Thank you.